Microbiome is this word we use to describe this invisible ecosystem of organisms that have a habitat or a shared habitat. And so what I mean by this is we're talking about viruses, we're talking about bacteria, we're talking about archaea, we're talking about fungi, and even other animal-like eukaryotes that we can't see. So this is an invisible world, and it permeates everything from within our bodies to outside of our bodies to every sort of surface that we live in and habitate. The one that we hear about most in public media and society is the gut microbiome. And in the gut microbiome, what we realize is that these microorganisms are actually breaking down chemicals that we can't actually ourselves break down. And in addition, they're producing vitamins that we ourselves in our own bodies cannot produce. And so there's a lot of interest in how do we harness those microbiomes for health and human benefit. Other areas of microbiome science that are exciting are in energy production. And so we know that microorganisms catalyze all of these energy production systems from natural gas wells to hydrocarbon-rich systems. And so we're trying to understand what roles they play and how we can harness their metabolisms to increase energy yields. Another interest is in soil systems for two reasons. One, microbes in soil systems actually produce greenhouse gases. And so we're talking about CO2 and methane and basically components that contribute to global climate change. Another area would be the agricultural microbiome, and I think this is a really exciting area. And it's this idea of, can we harness microorganisms in the soil to actually give beneficial value to crop systems?
Humans have about 3 pounds of microbes in and on their body. Most of them are in the gut, and these are mostly bacteria. In your gut microbiome, you actually share a lot of those microbes with people that you live with. If your partner or roommate is on antibiotics, it actually can affect your gut microbiome as well. So we also have microbes on our skin, and one really interesting thing about that is they're very personalized. And so the microbes on my skin are very unique to me, and when I touch something, I leave a unique fingerprint on that surface. And you can actually use that to link a surface back to the person who touched it.
I think what's really innovative about the CSU approach to microbiome science is we actually are housed in different departments, yet we all function as a community to really leverage microbiome sciences in a bunch of different disciplines.